Hello, how are you? How are you? Are you fine? Are you there? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Hello, Fede. Hello, Candela. Nico, Iram. Are you there? Can you hear me well? Can you? Can you hear me well? Okay, so we can start, and now what you have to do before you is your two last papers about your exam. And now we're going to do the review of this kind of. I know that my image is going and up and down, but this is not important now. So pay attention, and we're going to do the review of this this exercise. We remember. So you know that Spain is a democracy, and as in everywhere, democracy only works when people is aware about their rights and responsibilities. And you have here a full list of rights and responsibilities. What you had to do was to classify rightly all of them into these two kind of possibilities, so rights and responsibilities. And we're going to do the review, not the whole of it, only some of them. So what do you think about the first sentence? So we are all equal. So discrimination against a person is forbidden. What do you think about that? Is that a right, a responsibility? What do you think? What do you think? We are all equal. So discrimination against a person is forbidden. What do you think? Is that a right or a responsibility? What do you think? Waiting for you. Yes, this is a right, okay? We have a right not to be discriminated against. Very good. Now, let's go to number 5. We'll think about to respect the law. Is that a right or a responsibility of for all citizens? To respect the law. What do you think? What do you think? Number 5. To respect the law. To respect the law is, you think, waiting for you. To respect the law is yes, Victor. This is a responsibility for all citizens. And what about? Yes, you're right, all of you. Okay, very good. What about number 11? To respect public service. What do you think? To respect, not to use them, but to respect them. To respect schools, to respect hospitals, to respect roads. What do you think about number 11? To respect public service. Is that a right, or a responsibility? What do you think? What do you think? Take care with your spelling. Responsibility. Okay? So, to respect public service is another responsibility. Very good. And what do you think about number 8? To have a job. To have a job. Is that a right or a responsibility in a democracy? What do you think? To have a job. What about to have a job? To have a job is, take care, Pablo, Ithiar, with your spelling. Responsibility. Responsibility. Yes, Fran, to have a job is a right. We have, all of us, we have a right to have a job in the society. Very good, very good. So, now, it's, number two was an exercise about your school. So your school is a community, and you have to make a list of your rights and responsibilities. Responsibilities, pay attention to the spelling, responsibilities in the school. So a right is to be educated, a right is to have friends, a right is to be taught, and a responsibility is to work, You go to school because you have to work there. You can't go to school and not to work. So this is your responsibility, you have to study. Very good. And now, let's move to number three. So 3-1, this is important. Why is the 6th of December a national holiday in Spain? Why is it? Why is it? You remember? This is a very important date in Spain, 6th December. And this is a national holiday in Spain. Why is it? Why is this very date a national holiday in Spain? What do you think? 6th December, but not 5th, but not 10th. 6th December. This is, why is it? Why is it? Waiting for your answer. Why is it? Yes, yes, Constitution Day. Very good, very good. It's yes or not. Now, 3-2. Can a monarchy be part of a democracy? Only yes or not. Can a monarchy be part of a democracy? What do you think? 3-2. Can a monarchy be part of a democracy? Yes or not? Is that right or not? Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes. It can't, but not always. Not always. So, an example is Spain. Another example is United Kingdom. Many countries in Northern Europe are monarchies, and they are constitutional monarchies. Okay, very good. And number 3-3, this is interesting. What is direct democracy? What is direct democracy? Democracy is when all of us have a say in public affairs. And what is direct democracy? What is that? Direct democracy is when, for example, imagine your neighborhood, okay? Many neighbors of yours are living in the same building, and you have to take decisions, and all of you have to be asked about the things that are common. This is direct democracy. Okay, or imagine a little village, a little town, with just a few inhabitants, and the mayor there can exert direct democracy with their neighbors. So all of them. So this is direct democracy, and the opposite is representative democracy. So when you have a very large community of people, you can ask everybody for it, and you need representatives. And this is a representative democracy. In Spain and in every country in the world, there is live in our democracy, there is a representative democracy, and people elect their representatives. And now, 3-4, how old you have to be to vote in Spain? How old you have to be to vote in Spain? What do you think? You were right, Sartai. Okay, people decide the laws directly. through an assembly. Very good, very good, very good answer. Okay. Very good. Very good. But now, the question is, how old you had to be to vote in Spain? Very good, Candela Jover. You had to be, 18 years old. It's now 3-5. Can a dictatorship be a democracy? Can a dictatorship be a democracy? What do you think? Can it be a democracy, a dictatorship? Would you agree with that? Yes, maybe we are a dictatorship, but we have elections from time to time. No. No, never. Never. Okay. We know many things about that in Spain. And this is important. This is important. And this is a kind of greed. Oh. Sorry. Okay. So, go here. You have here a kind of chart. This is a scheme about our country, and you have to put here. You have to put here. Number one, number two, number three. You have to fill in these gaps, and you have to use these words. So number one, this is the most important law in every country, in Spain as well. So number one is the Constitution. Okay, Constitution. And then you have to fill in these other gaps. So you have three different branches, and these are the three different branches of power, okay, in Spain as in every country. And you have here in this branch you have number four, president, number nine. So who is the body that organize the country? You have to put here number four. What do you think? Number four, the name for the body, for the institution that organizes the country. What do you think? Number four. We are here. Number four. Can you see it? So this is one branch of power, this is another one, and this is another one. So the three branches of power. And this is the branch that organizes the country. Yes, yes, friend. It's the government. The government. And the government is composed of the president of the government. And these people here help the president out with the task of the government. And these are the ministers. So number four is the government, number nine are the ministers, and this is the branch, this is the executive branch. Now let's move to the central branch here. So we have number two, number five, seven, eight, and this is a clue, the deputies. So the deputies meet in the parliament. Okay, and the parliament in Spain is composed of two chambers, you remember. So the task of the parliament is, and you have to go here, is to develop laws. So develop laws is here, number two. Okay, this is the task of the legislative power. Okay, and number five is the institution that is in charge of making laws. And this is number five, you know, this is the parliament. Very good. This is the parliament. And the parliament is divided into two chambers. Number seven with the deputies, and number eight with, we don't know. So the deputies meet in the Congress. So seven, Congress. The Congress is the seat for the deputies, the place for the deputies. And number eight is the other chamber in Spain that is, yes, the Senate. And the Senate is composed of senators. So deputies and senators and the representatives that meet in the parliament, okay, the Congress and the Senate, and this is the second branch, not the second, but yes, second branch. Okay, very good. And finally, we have the judiciary. The judiciary, the task is to monitor if laws follow the Constitution. Number three is monitors if laws follow the Constitution. And for number six, we have justice. And the most important tribunal there is the Constitutional Court. Okay, and justice is composed of these people, judges and magistrates. This is important. Very good. Let's move. We need more time. Let's move to number five. And you have to say if these sentences are true or false. Okay, so let's go to 5.1. The Spanish Constitution is the most important law in Spain. What do you think? The Spanish Constitution is the most important law in Spain. Is that true or false? Your opinion. The Spanish Constitution is the most important law in Spain. What do you think? Number 5.1. True. Yes, the most important law is the Constitution. Very good, very good. So, it's 5.2. The king can change any law that he doesn't agree with. Is that true or false? The king, the head of state in Spain, can change any law that he doesn't agree with. Is that true or false? We are in 5.2. 5.2. Can the king change any law that he doesn't agree with? What do you think? No, he can't. No, he can't. This is a constitutional monarchy. This is a parliamentary monarchy. Okay. And you know that all Spanish people have the same rights but not the same responsibilities? This is false. This is false. Okay. Now, 5.4. The Spanish people elect their kings. Is that true? Is that true? 5.4. The Spanish people elect their kings. You think? You think? Do we elect our kings? What do you think? I'm waiting for you. Do we elect our kings? Is there any electoral campaign to elect our king? No, no. You can't elect your kings, okay? Okay. This is a feature, a very important feature of a monarchy. That's why many people don't want to be monarchic people, okay? Good. And finally, the ombudsman, Defensor del Pueblo in Spanish, is responsible for interpreting the Constitution and the constitutionality of laws. Attention, this is false. This is false, okay? The only body that can interpret the Constitution is the Constitutional Court, no court, not the Ombudsman, okay? The Ombudsman is a person with an office, with many people working with him or with her, to help out many people that have problems. Okay, so this is the Defensor del Pueblo. This is a very important office in Spain. Now, basically, I think this is very easy for you. Let's move to number seven. Number seven. So, you have to choose one of these possibilities. So we have, which is not a power of state, which is not a power of state. You can choose between judicial, legislative, local, or executive. Which is not a power of the state? One of them is wrong. Maybe judicial, maybe legislative, maybe local, maybe executive. Which is not a power of the state. So, you can answer A, B, C, D, you vote. Yes, local. This is not a power of the state. This is a level of administration. So the judicial, legislative, and executive are the three branches of power. So 7-2, which is not a level of administration, and you can choose between autonomic, national, local, or judiciary. Which is not a level of administration? What's your opinion? A, B, C, or D? One of these is wrong. Here. Yes, Pablo says D, but Pablo is the only one, not very sure. Pablo thinks that judiciary is not a level of administration. Yes, you're right. Okay, judiciary is not a level. The three levels of administrations are national, local, and autonomic. National, autonomic, and local. Judiciary is just a branch of power. Number 7-3. Which are the most important laws in Spain, only second to the Constitution? We know that the Constitution is the most important law in Spain, but which is the next one in importance? Traffic laws, they are very important. Statutes of autonomy, the national budget. The national budget is el presupuesto nacional. Or health care laws. What do you think? A, B, C, or D? A, B, C, or D? Pablo de Cabo is the fastest, but Santi agrees with him. Very good, Victor. Very good, Nico. Very good, very good. So, statutes of autonomy. Spain is a very decentralized country. Okay. Now, 7-4. What body decides if Parliament's laws follow the Constitution? The Constitutional Court, the Senate, the government, or the army? In a democracy. What do you think? 7-4. There is one body, an institution, that decides if Parliament's laws follow or not the Constitution. Could be the Senate or the army. No, the Constitutional Court. So you think that the Parliament has approved a bill that doesn't follow the Constitution? You can appeal. You can go to the Constitutional Court, and the Constitutional Court decides if this particular law follows or not the Constitution. And finally, 7-5. What kind of monarchy is Spain? An absolute monarchy? You have to think about King Philip II, or I don't know, King Philip V, Ferdinand VII. They were absolute monarchs. A theocratic monarchy. You have to think about a country that declares itself as Catholic or Muslim or Jew. A constitutional monarchy, a monarchy with a parliament, or an autocratic monarchy. Autocratic monarchy is more or less the same as absolute monarchy. And Spain is, yes, a constitutional monarchy. Very good. So we have more questions here, okay, but we can leave them for other day, because I'd like you to watch to some very interesting works made by you, and I'd like you to watch to this work that was made by Martin and Guille about Andalusia. and this is the Andalusian flag, you know, green, white, and green. You remember maybe the poem that I told you the other day about Lope de Vega, okay? By Lope de Vega, sorry, by Lope de Vega. Río de Sevilla, cuán grande eres, con galeras blancas y juncos verdes, okay? White and green. And this is the image of a myth, a Greek myth, Hercules. Okay? And this column is Europe, this other column is Africa, and in between, Andalusia, okay? Hercules. Very good, very good. And the political structure of Andalusia is composed of the parliament, the president, okay, and then we have 8 different provinces. This image here, this is the Palacio de San Telmo, and this is the place where the president of Andalusia meets, okay? This is the official place. Very good. Now, important economic activities there. You remember that there are 3 different sectors of economy, okay, in all countries, everywhere: the primary, secondary, and tertiary. And Andalusia is very important in many of them, okay. As for the primary sector, we have to remember that that Andalusia is very important in agriculture, but not only in agriculture, but only in mining. Okay, before Andalusia was one of the most important places in mining in the whole of Spain, and this is a demonstration of people in Andalusia that are asking or demanding better living conditions. And this is a picture about a mine called Aznalcóllar, with a very important problem there, okay, a mine. So, the secondary sector in Andalusia is composed of many, many industries, many companies there, okay, many companies. So, in Sevilla, in Algeciras is this is an interesting place. Maybe this part here, you can see the arrow here, my arrow. Maybe this is Africa, maybe. And this is one of the most important harbors in Spain, okay? But this belongs to the tertiary sector, because this is a service, right? In Seville, in many other places. Even in Algeciras, you can find very interesting companies such as Acerinox, many firms there. And the tertiary sector of the economy in Andalusia, most important is tourism, okay? So nowadays they are waiting for the tourists to come there, okay? I bet you know tourism in Andalusia very well. Very good, very good. It's more things about art and literature in Andalusia. You know, you remember this picture. This picture is by Picasso. Picasso was born in Malaga. Okay. Very good. Very good. And poets. And as for the physical relief of Andalusia, you have here a photo about, I don't know exactly where, okay? It looks like Sierra Nevada, but you have to think that Andalusia, the border of Andalusia with the Meseta, is Sierra Morena, and inside Andalusia we have a depression. And maybe this is the Guadalquivir River, and the Guadalquivir River is the river that marks the depression of Andalusia there, and is bordered by Sierra Morena and Cordillera Bética. This is Sierra Nevada in Granada province, Alcazaba in Granada, Mulathen, maybe you remember an exercise in maths the other day. Mulathen. Mulathen is the highest peak in the Iberian Peninsula. Mulathen, more than 3,000 meters. Very good. And as for rivers, you can see here some of them. The most important one is the Guadalquivir River. Okay, this is the Guadalquivir River, and you can see here this is Sierra Morena. Okay, to the north, and this part are the Vetic systems here, and this is Guadalquivir, the Lord of Andalusia, Guadalquivir, and Guadalquivir flows through Córdoba, Sevilla. Okay, and finally, Sanlúcar de Barrameda. You remember the poem of the other day, Sanlúcar de Barrameda. But we have more rivers. Guadiana. But Guadiana is just this part here. This part here. Guadiana doesn't flow through Andalusia. Only marks the border with Spain, or Andalusia if you want, with Portugal. Guadalete is a very interesting and a historic river in Spain, because here in the Guadalete River, in the banks of the Guadalete River, took place a very important battle between the Visigoths and the Muslims, and the Visigoths got defeated. The Guadalquivir River, this is Torre del Oro in Sevilla, the location in Spain. This is Ceuta and Melilla. These are the flags of Ceuta, this one, and this is Melilla's flag. And Andalusia marks a border with Portugal, clearly, okay, with Morocco, with the Gibraltar Strait, Algeria, it's Algeria, and this is flag of Gibraltar, okay, Gibraltar. You know that Spanish people consider Gibraltar as a Spanish possession. We respect the fact that Gibraltar is British, okay, but we claim that Gibraltar is ours. Don't forget that. And it's very important information about Andalusia is that in Andalusia you can find a lot of places that are World Heritage, Patrimonio de la Humanidad. So Alhambra de Granada is one place, not the city, not Granada. Only this place. This is the difference. For example, Alcalá de Henares, the place is considered a World Heritage at the university. But in Granada, just the Alhambra. Okay. Mezquita de Córdoba, Alcázar de Sevilla. Okay. There are many other places. Córdoba is a city that is considered a World Heritage. Úbeda, Baeza, two more places, and Seville is the capital city. Okay, these are some these are the provinces: Seville, Flamenco, Huelva. Okay, we have a lot of time. Cádiz. Okay, Cádiz. You have here the coat of arms of Cádiz. Hercules here, and the two columns. So, Europe and Africa with the lions, the tamed lions, leones domados. Málaga, another important place. You know that there are 5 coastal provinces and 3 inland provinces in Andalusia. Córdoba is one of the inland provinces. Córdoba is a World Heritage. A UNESCO site. This is the Mosque of Córdoba. Beautiful. Okay. The Alcázar of Córdoba. Jaén, another inland province. Jaén is famous by its olive trees. And you see them here. Okay. In Jaén. Granada. Was the last kingdom of the Muslims when the Catholic monarchs conquered it. Know it? Poblado Unfaldirke, this is another town. I think these are reasons for you to visit there. Almería. Okay, this is Alcazaba. Alcazaba means castillo. Alcazaba, Alcázar, Alcalá. All these words came from the Arabic and means castles. All of them. And they recommend us to go there because of many things. Okay, very good. A good sense of humor. And this is food, special food. Pescadito frito. Very good. This is, I can't remember the name. It's not gazpacho. This is, I can't remember the name. Flamenco culture. Very good. I think we have. We have time to go to another work if you are patient. I'd like you to watch and to value this work about Extremadura. And this work was made by Fede. And Fede had to do it without PowerPoint. And that's why he did it with his own handwriting. This is the flag of Extremadura, so green, white, and black. And this is Fede's handwriting. So Extremadura is a Spanish autonomous community located in the southern part of the Iberian Peninsula, and it's made of two provinces, Cáceres and Badajoz, capital Mérida. Very good. Okay. This is about Extremadura Day. Okay, I didn't know that. Okay, take care of the spelling, Fede. Very good. And is the cradle, is la cuna of the most famous conquerors of the New World. Okay, they are proud of them. Okay, good. And the climate of this territory is warm in the south and temperate in the north, which is true. Very good. Now. You have here again the Extremadura flag. This is the location in Spain. Okay, so Madrid, Castilla-La Mancha, and Cáceres, Mérida, the capital of the region, and Badajoz. Badajoz is very near the border with Portugal. Good, and this is the map. Another map. Okay, this is a political map. Okay, this is Cáceres. And this is Badajoz. Badajoz, can you see here? Cáceres is here. They're very near. Okay. No more than 70 kilometers from one to another. And here, Mérida. Remember that Mérida is the capital of Extremadura because of historical reasons. Okay. Mérida was the most important Roman city in Hispania. And this is the map. This is the map about. Map of maybe this is better. So you can see here two rivers. This is Tagus River, okay, that flows across Cáceres westwards, okay, going to Lisbon, and this is Guadiana River, and in between mountain range. Good, very good. Okay, this is Guadiana River. Guadiana River enters Extremadura and marks a border with Portugal here, goes to Portugal, and then returns to make the border in Andalusia with Portugal. And this is the images of two historical people there. This is Francisco Pizarro. Francisco Pizarro, that was born in Trujillo. He was the conqueror of Peru. Francisco Pizarro, this is Hernán Cortés, the conqueror of Mexico. They were from Extremadura. This is the end. But before, you have to remember this magnificent building. This is the theater. You can see it. You can visit when you go to Mérida. You can go to visit these ruins. And today, in, not today, but every summer here in this very place, you can watch a lot of plays, in summer. And here below, you, maybe you can here be oh, here. Can you see here? This is the cloister, the claustro of Guadalupe, the monastery of Guadalupe. Okay, very good, very good. We don't have more time. Next day we're going to continue with your presentations. I remember, I remind you that not all of you sent your presentation to me, and you are running out of time, and you need to do more presentations in this new unit, okay? But you'll get some more news for me about that. Now, please, we meet in just...